everyone, welcome to another unboxing video. This time we are going through unboxing of Gigabyte Aorus Z590 Elite AX Gaming Motherboard with LGA 1200 socket. The motherboard has direct 12 plus 1 phases digital voltage regulator module, in short VRM solution for powering your CPU, and it has PCI Express 4, USB 3.2 Gen 2 and integrated Wi-Fi module. Now let me pull out the motherboard itself, which is nicely wrapped in protective anti-static plastic bag, and I can start opening it by peeling off the transparent tape. This motherboard is brand new, and when buying used one, make sure it is wrapped in this anti-static plastic bag to avoid microchips damages. On the first look, the motherboard colors are in metal black with silver accent. It has very nice layout of VRM around the CPU socket, nice heatsink for M.2 SSD disks, and on connector panel side, it seems to have enough connectors for our external peripherals. On the back side, there are just very few SMD components and nice backplate of CPU socket. And it also has nice Aorus logo on chipset heatsink. Now let's explore what accessories we have bundled in the box, and by opening the bottom cover we'll find multilingual installation guide which has enough images to explain memory module installation. On next page we'll find CPU heatsink installation guidance, CPU installation guidance for socket LGA 1200, guidance for motherboard installation into PC case, expansion cards installation into PCI Express slots, and on backside we have power supply installation guidance, as well as BD-ROM and hard drive installation guidance, and finally the motherboard power connector connection guidance, CPU power connector connection guidance, and front panel connector connections guidance. Next artifact is the user manual for Aorus Elite Z590 motherboard, and this one will contain very detailed explanation of all individual components and modules and sockets on the motherboard. It will also contain the BIOS user interface explanation. Next artifact is a brief user manual in French language describing placement of individual parts on the motherboard. I can't speak French yet, but nice image anyway. Now let's move on to the next artifact in the box, and it is the brief manual on how to install the APP Center application, where we will be able to manage drivers for our motherboard, as well as able to download latest BIOS and other supporting applications. Then we have a G connector with front panel connection labels. I am not going to use this one as I'll be installing the motherboard into NZXT H510 Elite PC case, and that one has very nice front panel connectors which will fit directly into motherboard. Next artifact is the Wi-Fi antenna with a cable to connect the Wi-Fi connector on the connector panel. Let me put it back to the box as I will be mainly using Ethernet cable for my internet connection. On other side of the box shelf we have Aorus badge as a sticker. Next artifact in the box is a plastic bag with two SATA cables with transfer speed up to 6 GB per second. Then we have another plastic bag with two more SATA cables. I will not be using these as I will be mounting the SSD disk into the M.2 PCI Express 4.0 slot on the motherboard. And last artifact are three plastic bags with set of screws, which I believe are for mounting the M.2 SSD disks. And that would be it, nothing else in the box. Now let's flip over the motherboard and we'll start installing the backplate of our CPU bracket. Someone prefers to mount it after the motherboard is placed into the PC case, but I prefer first to check if everything fits in properly. I'll just position 4 threads on the backplate in a direction to 4 holes around the CPU slot, and I will make sure that it aligns well and all threads fits in. Now let's flip the motherboard back and we can see that there are 4 thread holes, and this is where we need to place our standoffs. The standoffs will be in the package of your CPU cooler. In my case I had a plastic bag with set of standoffs as part of the NZXT Kraken Z63 package. And if you have not seen video of unboxing and mounting of that one, make sure you check it out by opening the new tab with the link popping up in the top right corner. Now let me screw in the standoffs into the CPU cooler bracket backplate. There were actually 2 sets of standoffs in the package, so make sure you pick the correct ones. And I'm going to speed up the video just to show I'm really mounting in all of the 4 standoffs. And now is the time to start placing the motherboard into our PC case. I am placing it into NZXT H510 Elite PC case. And let me know down in the comments which PC case did you choose for your Gigabyte Aorus motherboard. This is an ATX form factor motherboard with size 30.5 cm by 24.4 cm or 12 inches by 9.6 inches. I have already prepared the powering cables from 850 watts PSU unit, and if you are interested to see unboxing of that one, make sure you open the new tab with the link popping up in the top right corner. And now is the time to tighten up our motherboard into NZXT PC case. This will be similar even for new lineup of NZXT H7 PC cases, and the screws were actually present in the box of my NZXT case. Now let me loosen the screw holding the heatsink on top of the M.2 SSD disk slot. This is the one with full PCI Express 4.0 design. There are two more M.2 slots present on the motherboard, but those support only PCI Express 3.0. The heatsink has a thermal pad which will ensure our PCI Express M.2 SSD disk will not be overheating. Now let me put the heatsink aside for a while, and I just noticed I have forgot to tighten in one screw. So let me quickly fix it and we can proceed to start connecting the power connectors from my power supply unit. Very first I'm going to connect the 24 pin connector. I just have to bend the thick cable a little bit and let's make sure we hear the click sound. Then we can do a little bit of the cable management. The connector can fit only in one direction, so it cannot happen you would plug it in incorrect way. Now let's connect our CPU power cables. This motherboard has 3 4-pin connectors, but other types of motherboard might have different count of 4-pin connectors based on the VRM setup of the motherboard. Let me bend the cable and I'm going to plug in first connector. Again, the click sound is important here, then second connector and finally third connector. There is very little space, but eventually I have managed. Now let's just do final check that all connectors are properly connected. There is one redundant 4-pin connector, so let me push it through the hole to the back of the PC case, and then very important test would be to see if our fan is spinning without any resistance from incorrect cable management. Now let me plug in the USB 3.1 Gen 1 connector. This is coming from the USB connector on top of the PC case. Let's plug it into USB 3.2 connector on motherboard, and I'll also do proper cable management. Then we also have USB 3.2 Gen 2 connector, which is coming from the USB Type-C connector on top of the PC case. So let me remove the cover and I can plug it into USB Type-C header on motherboard, which supports USB 3.2 Gen 2. The click sound is important, and now let's connect the front panel audio connector to the motherboard. The front panel with audio jack is actually on top of the NZXT PC cases, so let's just make sure it is connected properly to the motherboard for the correct function. We also have to connect the USB 2.0 connector to power up our smart device, which is pre-installed in NZXT H510 PC case. So let's plug it in and let's also do a little bit of cable management to hide the cable into the hole under the bottom of motherboard. And through that one we are also routing our front panel connector. There was an adapter as part of the NZXT PC case for non-Intel motherboards, but we are not going to use that one and will plug in the front panel connector into motherboard's front panel slot. And after another round of cable management, let's not forget to connect the USB cable, which on other side has micro USB connector, which is connected to our NZXT Kraken Z63 liquid cooler pump. To summarize connectors at the bottom of our motherboard, on very left we have connected audio connector, then USB from our Kraken Z63 liquid cooler pump, then USB connector from our NZXT smart device, and on very right we have connected our front panel cable. Now a little bit of a teaser from one of my next video where I will be unboxing the M.2 SSD disk and DDR4 memory modules with Rgb, which synchronizes well with the Rgb on the motherboard. As well as I'll be unboxing and mounting the CPU and mounting the Kraken Z63 liquid cooler pump to the LGA 1200 bracket. So don't hesitate to hit the subscribe button to do not miss the unboxing of those components. Let's also use the CPU fan slot on top of the motherboard, and here we are going to connect the connector from our NZXT Kraken Z63 liquid cooler pump. I have been connecting other cables from liquid cooler in one of my previous videos, so make sure you check my channel for more videos. But just for completeness, let's connect the micro USB cable into micro USB slot on the NZXT Kraken Z63 liquid cooler pump. And on the back panel of motherboard, on top we have 4 USB 2.0 slots, 2 Wi-Fi antenna connectors, display port, 2 USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type A ports, 1 USB Type C port and USB 3.2 Gen 1 port next to it, then another 2 USB Gen 1 ports, then RJ45 LAN port for 2.5 gigabits per second speed, and optical out connector and line-in/line-out audio connectors are at the bottom of the back panel. Now let's connect the power cord to power supply unit, and now we can power on our PC and let's see if all our RGB lights are going to lighten up. Our Aorus logo on motherboard is lighting up, our liquid cooler pump has lightened up, and our memory modules are going to lighten up now. You can notice I do not have graphic card installed in the PCI Express slot of the Gigabyte Aorus Elite AX motherboard. And if you are interested to see which GPU I have chosen, make sure you open the new tab with the link in top right corner. This motherboard has DisplayPort connector on the backplate, so I can just plug in the DisplayPort cable from my external monitor and I can start checking the BIOS settings. For this to function properly, make sure you choose CPU with integrated Intel GPU, and with that I can just build the PC and troubleshoot the BIOS settings without the need of GPU component. I can also install the Windows, and after installation of Windows, there is one more feature I want to show you, and that is the Rgb synchronization across the components. You can install the Gigabyte Rgb Fusion application, and within the application you can choose different Rgb effects, as well as you can choose your custom colors for the Rgb light of the Aorus logo on motherboard, Gigabyte logo on GPU, and Rgb on memory modules. And to summarize this motherboard, I like the connectors layout on the motherboard, RGB synchronization across the components, many USB connectors on back panel, support for integrated GPU in CPU with DisplayPort connector on back panel, support for both 10th gen Intel CPU and 11th gen CPU, PCI Express 4 with support for high-speed M.2 SSD disk, and most importantly very good VRM for powering the CPU, so in overall very good motherboard. And until my next video, cheers!